Hi, I'm Dr. Doe from Oceanside, California. I'm the team captain for Team Super Marrow in the Race Across America 2019. What? I hear a child is in trouble. This is Captain America of Team Super Marrow. We will be riding our bike across America this June to encourage everyone, especially those of Asian and Hispanic ethnicity and any ethnic minority, to enroll in our National Stem Cell Donor Registry. Together, we can save lives. Watch us on Binge Network TV. And welcome to the OhioRAAM Show.
Thank you, Dr. Doe, alias Super Marrow, for your introduction. And Dr. Doe and his Super Marrow team will be on the show on May the 17th. And my name is Lee Kreider. I am the producer of the OhioRAAM Show, a show about ultracycling. And this show comes to you three times a month on the 7th, 17th, and 27th. The OhioRAAM Show is a service of the time stations in Ohio on the Race Across America, Time Station 41 in Oxford, 42 in Blanchester, and 43 in Chillicothe. The dates of this year's Race Across America are on the screen there for you to see, particularly paying attention to the dates when we expect the riders through our time stations in Ohio, and we welcome all of you to come out and visit us as these racers are passing by. There'll be more information on how you can know when that's going to happen in a later show. And be sure to check the show notes. They're right below this video on OhioRAAMShow.com website. If you're watching on YouTube, you'll see a link to this site in the description box. Well, on today's show, we're going to go down to Austin, Texas to visit with Christie Tracie, who has had quite a bit of ultracycling experience, cycling, road racing, criterium racing, gravel racing. Tracie rode the World Time Trial Championship 12 hours last fall with a broken hip, or I should say a broken hip that was healing, not quite healed. And since we recorded this broadcast, lo and behold, she fell again in a gravel race and broke the hip again. So off to Austin, Texas.
Okay.
So Christie, how are you doing this evening?
I'm doing well, thank you.
Down there in... What's the temperature down in Austin tonight?
Right now, we're probably in the 50s, upper 40s, low 50s.
Tell me about your cycling experience. You're relatively new to this sport, aren't you?
I am. I started on a dare, actually, from a friend. She dared me on my birthday. I think it was like my 33rd or 34th birthday. There was a sprint triathlon coming through town. I lived in Corpus Christi at the time. She dared me to join the sprint try on my birthday, and I hadn't swam since probably elementary school. I hadn't been on a bike since probably elementary school, and I certainly hadn't run. I was very much a weightlifter at the time. So it sounded like, sure, why not? Let's do it. Thank goodness they canceled the swim, or I probably wouldn't be here to tell this story. And the run was horrible. But I loved the bike. I fell in love with the bike. And it was on my birthday. And I told my husband that I wanted to buy a road bike for my birthday the very next day. And I really haven't looked back since.
When it comes to cycling, it looks like you've done about everything there is. You've done road racing. Mm-hmm. You've done criteriums. You've done ultras. And you've done gravel. You have quite a well-rounded repertoire.
I started out road racing. I don't do anything halfway. My very first road race was the state championship. It was one of those things where I'd been training for a while. I'd hired a coach. A friend had told me about the state championship and said it was coming up in a month. And I talked to my coach and I said, hey, do you think, you know, I want to see how I compare against real bike racers. I've been riding a bike for a couple months now and I just want to see how it goes. And he said, go for it. So yeah, I jumped into the road race and I got popped and finished by myself. One of the addicting things about cycling is the improvement, the personal improvement, and the fact that if you continue to work at it, you're going to naturally get better and better. And so I got popped from the lead group. You know, I wasn't able to stay connected with the lead group in my very first road race because it was a state championship and I was in way over my head. I had no group riding skills. But the next time that I did a road race, I hung on a little bit longer and then a little bit longer. And then eventually I was finishing with the lead group. And then eventually I was actually, you know, winning or finishing towards the front of the lead group. So a couple of friends said, you know, you should try this criterium racing thing. We have the driveway series here in Austin, Texas. So I lived in Corpus Christi at the time. It's about 3.5 hours south of Austin. So I made the drive up one Wednesday night and did the criterium races on Thursday and absolutely fell in love with it. Pretty much the exact opposite of ultra racing. It's 45 minutes, pretty much flat out as hard as you can go. Crazy, but it's a really good adrenaline rush. And long story short, ended up moving to Austin because of bike racing and the cycling community.
You made the transition from road racing to ultra. Tell me how that happened.
Pace Bend was the very first one. And it was the 6-hour Pace Bend ultra race run by Holland Racing. I am an engine. My strength is, I'm not very good at criteriums. I enjoy them, but I'm not great at them. I'm good at just motoring, finding a hard, comfortable pace, settling into that pain cave and just going, getting comfortable with the pain. So I found really quickly that ultra racing suits that, or that suits ultra racing. I won the women's category at the 6-hour Pace Bend and was hooked. Immediately registered for my next one, which was the 200-mile RAAM challenge, and just kind of went from there. And so I just really fell in love with the solo miles on the bike. The fact that you can settle in and just motor in your own little world, and it's not as high adrenaline, but I'm very type A. So my brain is constantly listing and tasking and going nonstop. When I'm like day to day, when I wake up, my brain turns on and it doesn't stop. And when I clip into my bike, I don't know what it is, but something shuts off. And it's just white noise. And it's this wonderful piece. So for me, 6 or 12 hours on my bike racing, where all I'm thinking about is riding my bike and nothing else, is 6 hours or 12 hours of peace. And so that's what really made me fall in love too with the ultra racing. I guess the only difficult part was learning to manage your effort and not go out quite so hard. If you burn too many matches in that first half an hour or hour, then you are going to be in a world of hurt.
From your bio, it would appear that you are mixing road and ultra even yet today.
Yes.
And you go back and forth with some degree of ease?
I do. And part of it is the social circles. I'm so ingrained in the road community here in Austin. And so many of my friends are involved in the road community. And we joke, Andrew and I, actually, about pulling them over to the dark side and pulling them over to ultra racing, because I love the ultra racing community too. And there is some overlap, but then there's also some very distinctly different things. And I enjoy so much about both of them that I honestly don't struggle with it. The only struggle, I guess, would be when you do an ultra race, especially the ones Andrew does. I mean, my niche is 12 hour. When I do a 12 hour race, it will drain the tank completely and it takes you some time to recover.
The 2017 World Time Trials, you turned in quite a performance there, didn't you?
I did. Thank you. We decided to make it, to not worry about what anybody else was doing. We went out and I hit the numbers that I was supposed to hit at the end of the day. Those numbers ended up being enough to win the championship. 252, I think.
Okay, now let's move on to 2018. But you had something of a disappointment before you got there, didn't you?
I was racing a criterium. It was actually at the driveway series, and I was in the leader's jersey. There was a big pile up in the sprint finish, and I got caught up in it and ended up fracturing my pelvis. I was completely non-weight bearing for 8 weeks, but I was pretty determined to get back out there and to try to defend that title.
How did the 2018 World Time Trials go for you then?
I did the 12 hour, and to add insult to injury, I came down with a stomach bug the night before, and I went into the race fairly dehydrated. I won 30 to 39 category and finished third overall.
Do you have any thoughts of longer distances in your future, and what might you have in mind?
Bucket list, I've got RAAM, but that's definitely a ways down the road. I want to ramp up and start by doing the Hoodoo 500 and the Silver State, then race across the West. Eventually, I'd love to do RAAM. Oh, and I can't forget NOCOM.
Christie, thank you for being with us, and we certainly wish you well.
Thank you, Lee. I appreciate it.
Well, thanks, Christie, for being with us, and we wish you heal well. And we're happy to say that Christie will be the guest host on the next show, which we'll talk about in a moment. And thank all of you for watching the show, and we thank you who give us your likes and shares on the social media. Our next show will be on April 7th, and we will bring Sandy Taylor and Molly Burt, who are specialists in equine medicine at Purdue University, and they have a wonderful charity of helping people in countries that depend a lot on the power of horses, mules, donkeys, and how they help them with medicine, with care, with nutrition, and other things to give a better life not only to the people who use these animals, but to the animals themselves. We're looking forward to talking with them. Until then, goodbye. See you in about 10 days.
Music by Kevin MacLeod.